Hi, welcome all of you. My name is Ashish and this is the new course that we are starting today. It is regarding the DevOps. Well, there has been so much of talks these days, like what is DevOps? What exactly is DevOps? How do I learn DevOps? I don't know programming. I don't know nothing about this fancy terminology like CI, CD. What is container services? What are microservices? What is the serverless environment? What is Git? What is the version control? What is all this? So today I'm starting this new course and I would upload the videos on YouTube under my channel. So if you don't want to miss out on any new topic that I'll post on YouTube, you have to subscribe to this channel right now and share it with your friends who are looking for the easy and conceptual training on DevOps. So the first video is just an overview regarding the many terminologies or many new concepts that we would have in DevOps. So what is DevOps? It is an overview I share with all of you guys. So definition, it's the essential DevOps practices include agile planning, continuous integration, continuous delivery and monitoring of applications. There are a few more things that are included, but that is altogether a different broad topic, like the container services, Azure Kubernetes, Docker, and the automation, the orchestration using Chef and Puppet and Ansible, Terraform, your Jenkins for the specific tool for CI/CD. So in broad term, you plan the software that you are trying to build, you build it, you do the continuous integration, then you deploy it, you operate it, you get the feedback, then you plan it again. So it's a collaboration of team that you do while you are implementing the DevOps practice in your software development and planning. The common questions we have is, what is DevOps? Why does DevOps matter? Why should I know DevOps and why should I implement it now? Am I too late? I'm too early? Is it worth it to know and learn DevOps or to apply DevOps in my routine in software development or my studying or my give a kick start to my career? Will answer to these questions as well. So how do you achieve DevOps successfully? You are on a learning track, but how would you achieve it? And etc. With the progression of course, we will put in more questions and we'll try to answer all of your questions to clear all of your doubts. Benefits of adopting DevOps. You shorten your cycle time by working in smaller batches. Rather than implementing the course in one go, you divide it in different sprints, scrums, batches to tell your developer to develop shorter packages for the whole package. Then you test it, deploy it, do the integration, get the feedback, you fix the bugs, you adapt a patch, you apply the patch, you make a patch. Slowly and steadily, you do it in smaller batches. You use more automation while you adopt DevOps. You harden your release pipelines. I know it's a fancy term, but we will harden the pipeline as well. You improve your telemetry of data that you are going to implement. You deploy the code more frequently. If you have been given a task to deploy or to develop a code, which more than 10,000 lines of code, it would take you more time and you would not be able to deploy that code that frequently. So you deploy in smaller batches and then you deploy it more frequently. Then you optimize your validate learning. You deploy in smaller batches, you deploy more frequently, you get more frequent feedbacks, right? You optimize your mistakes, you optimize your bugs, you optimize your patches, and you optimize your validations process and learning as well. Then how to achieve DevOps? You told me the number of benefits, questions, the process. Now, how should I achieve DevOps? Okay, you can achieve DevOps by implementing continuous integration, implementing continuous deployment. You should be aware of version control with Git or any other version control repository, open source or not an open source. You should be aware about agile management. What is agile management? You should be aware about your monitoring and logging, brief overview of public and hybrid clouds, and you should be aware of infrastructure as code, which is to automate your deployment in clouds, how you deploy the number of n number of virtual machines or application resources in cloud using automation or through code. It can be Python, it can be the templates, partial templates, it can be .NET, it can be any network which is supported with your version of public or hybrid cloud. Okay, so that was it, and I'm sure that you would be willing to go through more of these sections, and I'll see you in the next video wherein we will discuss continuous integration. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and share this video with your friends and anywhere you want to and everywhere you want to. Till then, till the next video, you have a great day.